Hello, my viewer. I still remain your brother, Pastor Smart Nachi. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to look at the best way to do snail farming, and that is what this video is going to take care of. In the next few minutes, I shall be showing you from A to Z the essentials in snail farming, how you can do snail farming successfully and make millions out of it. The first thing you have to consider, so long as snail farming is concerned, is the structure. One would ask, what type of structure do I build and use it for snail farming? We have many things you can use for snail farming, but I'll just mention four of them. The first one is old tire pen. Old tire pen is where you want to use condemned tires to do snail farming. Though that one will be possible if you want to do it in a small capacity. But if you are going into commercial snail farming, using old tire pen will be cumbersome for a beginner. And another one is the hunch boxes, where you use boxes. In our subsequent videos, I'll bring out these structures for you to see, and I'll do explanations on them. We have hunch boxes, where you can use boxes to do snail farming. We have trench pen. The trench pen is when you want to do snail farming right in the ground. You dig a trench in the ground, construct it very well, and use it for snail farming. I'll still do explanation on that in my subsequent video. But today we are concentrating on free range pen. Free range pen is where you do snail farming in a structured environment. A structured environment, I mean, is that a very large space of environment, you build it very well and use it for snail farming. In fact, snails love the free range pen because of the spacious nature of it. It gives them freedom to creep around freely without any form of restriction. And that is why, while they are in the free range pen, they still think they are in the wild, where they have the freedom to creep freely around. So today, this video is going to take care of how to do snail farming in a free range pen. So if you take a view, you will see the free range pen I have here. This one is under construction, and that is why it is important for us to teach you, the viewer, how to do snail farming using the free range pen, so that as you watch the construction, you will be able to know how to construct your own without even seeking professional help. So as you follow me, I have to take you through the structure we have here. This is a standard free range pen we are building. Look at it very well. You see the partitioning is clearly spelled out. This is the main farm. This is the main farm where the adult snails will be kept. This is the main farm where adult snails will be kept for rearing. Then, if you look at this very partitions by my right and my left, you see small structure. These ones will serve as hatchery. You know, you do not hatch snail eggs right in the farm where you have the big snails. That's the parent snails. If you hatch the eggs there, it's not that they are not going to hatch, but the problem would be when they hatch, they may not be able to survive because of the adult snails in their midst. The pressure from these adult snails will kill them. And that is why when you want to do snail farming, you make provision for your major farm and then make provision for hatchery. These are places where the eggs that come from this farm will be hatched. We have two hatchery right in front of the major farm. Okay? Now, another thing you look at in constructing free range pens is the netting. You know, there are predators. I will come to that anyway. The structure, the body of this very farm will be netted with wire mesh. With wire mesh. The reason for using wire mesh is that snails don't like creeping on wire mesh. You see, we have a dwarf foundation up to 3 coaches of blocks, and from this very level up will be covered with wire mesh. The reason is that you would not like your snails to creep up to the roof, because if it gets up to the roof, anything can happen to them. They may find opening to escape out of this farm. So since they don't like creeping on wire mesh, when you raise the wall to a certain level, you complete the remaining space with the wire mesh. As they creep around this wall, when they get to the wire mesh, it will be uncomfortable for them. So the next thing that will happen is that you see them going back to the soil again. And why this wire mesh is important is also to prevent intruders. There are predators that when they intrude into this farm, they end up harming the snails, killing and eating them up. So the wire mesh will provide this barrication so that the intruders, the predators, cannot find any opening through which they will enter into this farm. And also your snails cannot escape out of it. In as much as you want to do the farming, you also make provisions so that they will be safe in the farm without escaping. You know, the night is a long period of time so long as snails are concerned. All the activities, 95% of the activities are done in the night. So once it is 7 p.m., you see them becoming extraordinarily active. They creep around, they go around, they look for food, they do all sorts of things. So this place must be well built to take care of such situations. So having looked at it, the next thing about the structure is that the floor must be cemented. Though the floor will not be like this during the farming, we are still doing the construction. But after this, we are going to fill this floor with the right soil. And the soil, the level of the soil will be up to 5-6 inches above the ground level. The reason why this farm must be cemented is because there are predators that can creep from the ground, that can manifest in the farm through the ground. When you do the cementing of the floor, it will not be easy for any predator to be found in this very place. So you see, as you can see, we have done the cementing is already done. So the next thing now is that after the netting, after we've done everything, you will now have to fill this place up with the right soil. So having taken note of that, another major thing is that there would be need for trench outside this very structure to prevent creeping predators from having access into this farm. There are predators that when you allow them to gain access freely into the farm, your snails will hardly survive. We have soldier ants. If soldier ants have free access into the farm, they attack and kill snails. So you must build a trench that will not give them access into this farm. We have other things. We have other predators like the earwing. Earwing is an insect with red and black color on the body. This insect feeds on snails. Most of the times, if you see empty snail shell, you often see this earwing right inside that empty snail shell. So this trench is important to prevent those things, those creeping creatures that preys on snails from entering into the farm. We have also millipedes. If millipede is allowed into this farm, your snails are bound to die. We have rats, we have cats, we have lizards, and also we have snake. So that is why you must have to build a small trench outside, round about this farm. Let me show you what I mean by small trench. If you look at the floor, this is just the doormat of this farm. If you look at the floor immediately after it, you will see something like a small gutter built outside some inches away from the farm. So you see it, this thing will go round the farm. It will be taken round the farm. so that those sleeping predators that can enter and prey on snails will not have access into it. What do I mean by that? You know, after building this very trench round about this farm, well, from time to time, the manager of the farm, the one who will take care of this farm, will fill this very trench, this trench you are seeing here, will fill it up with water and will maintain that water regularly. So after this water has been filled into this trench, then they will look for condemned engine oil and pour onto the water. They will pour this condemned engine oil on the water. You know, when that is done, the engine oil will be floating on the surface of this water. So any creeping predator that enters this trench will have no other option but to die right in the trench by the reason of the condemned engine oil in the water. Snakes cannot access this trench now from outside through this place. They cannot fly into it. So they must have to creep through the trench to be able to have access into the trench. So with the condemned engine oil, as they creep through it, they will die. The same thing is applicable to soldier ants. The same thing is applicable to earwings. It's also applicable to a millipede. It's also applicable to lizards and the rest. So that is why it is important that this trench will be built outside this farm, land apart, so that these predators cannot gain access. So when you have done that, you have prevented them from entering. You have also prevented them from manifesting the farm as a result of cementing the floor. Then you will have nothing to worry about so long as predators are confined. That is how you build a successful snail farm, especially free-range pen. You must take care of these things. You must build a structure that will serve the purpose of snail farming. Then also you must build a structure for hatchery. Don't forget that. You will also have to build a structure that will not allow predators gaining access into the farm. So that's why the flooring is important. The trench is also important so that these predators cannot have access into this place. Again, you must net the free range pen all over. There will not be any single space left, because in as much as you have prevented predators from entering, you also need to prevent them from, you know, if you look at the wall here, the fence where this farm is attached, if you do not net this roof, the space close to the roof, these predators you are preventing from this farm will gain access into it through the opening close to the roof. So this place must be netted completely, and you will now be rest assured that you have a successful snail farm. Okay, then after the building, after the structure, the other thing you also need to consider is the environment. You must consider the environment because it is important. You don't just start snail farming wherever you like. You do snail farming in a place that is surrounded with plants, with trees, with leaves and the rest, vegetation. Like if you look at the environment where this very farm is situated, you can see all manner of, you see maize, you see plantain, you see pawpaw, you see other plants around. These plants will serve important people so long as this very family is concerned. What they do is that is to prevent direct wind from having access to the snails. You know, when these direct winds have close direct contact with the snails you keep here will be suffering from dehydration from time to time. So with this plant surrounding this very environment, every wind that will have access to the snails will first of all contend with the plants around. by contending with these plants, the pressure of that wind would have been reduced drastically even before having access to the snail. So by the time this wind will gain access into this farm, it would have become air than wind. So that is one thing you have to consider. The place you want to build the farm is important. If it doesn't have plants like this, you may start planting some as soon as you want to start, so that before this snail should be brought in, the plant would have been well established. Then another thing also is that the roofing is important. You don't just use snail farm and you leave it on roof. If you leave it on roof, you have also exposed the snails you will keep here to danger, because when they have direct access to the sun, when they have direct contact with the sun, the snails will suffer from dehydration. So you see your snails dying from time to time. So you must roof it. The roof serves dual purpose. Number one is that it will prevent the sun from having direct access to the snails you keep here. Then number two also is that it will prevent rain from having direct access. You need to wet this place, but the floor must not be waterlogged. So if it is not roofed, when there is heavy downpour, the floor, the farm, the soil will be waterlogged. And once that happens, it will no longer be comfortable for the snails to dwell in such a place. So that is why you need to roof the place to prevent the rain and the sun. And you know, if I may go further than this, when your snails begin to suffer from dehydration, you see, the ability to lay healthy and massive eggs will reduce. You see, they will now begin to struggle to lay eggs. And again, from there, it will graduate to a time when you begin to see them looking pale all the time. You see, some snails, you 1-2 days remaining at the spot, not making any move, even when they are alive, is as a result of the dehydration. Then from that very point, it will get to a time when you see whitish substance covering the shell completely. It is also as a result of dehydration. And from that spot, if nothing is done to check it, you will see them dying one after the other. So you will have to avoid dehydration. That is the much I can take on this. By the time we are through with the structure, so we will bring you another video about the stocking. So that the other things I have not said now will be said when the structure is completed. We will show you a video of the structure for the farming. And also, we will also show you a video of how to introduce the snails and how to provide their food for them. But for now, I have to leave you with the video you are watching. In case you want more of it, look below the screen. You see a red button. Click on it. You will subscribe to my channel. And as time progresses, regularly I'll be bringing you videos of successful farms and how to start one. In case you want to get across to me, my number still remains 08063 790002. If you are calling outside Nigeria, then endeavor to add +234 +234. That is +234 8063 790002. Please don't fail to watch the second video about the snail farming I have just shown you. The second video will come with comprehensive teaching on snail farming. This is just about building, having a structure for it. We will now look into getting the snails, introducing the snails, feeding the snails, and how to hatch the snail eggs. I want to promise you that one will be explosive. Do not miss it. Until that time, stay blessed in Jesus' name.